Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about what is SSIS and what are the use of SSIS. And then we will discuss about what is the control flow and data flow. So let's start. So first of all, what is SSIS? SSIS means SQL Server Integration Services. So SQL Server Integration Services is a component of Microsoft SQL Server database software that can be used to perform a broad range of data migration. So we can say that SQL Server is a tool by which we can do data integration and workflow applications. Next is, what is ETL? So ETL is a three-step process. First is extract, then transformation, and then load. So extract data from different sources is our first process. Then we need to use some transformation by which our business requirement will be fulfilled. And our last step is load data into our database. So this is our control flow. So before going forward, I would like to explain how we can start with SSIS. So first of all, we need to go on start and then we need to type SQL Server data tool. So as you can see over here, we need to open it. So this is our start page for SSIS. We need to go to one file, then new, and go to one project. So here we can see we have business intelligence. Inside we have three options. First is analysis services, then integration services, then reporting services. So now we are talking about integration services. Here we need to select our first option and we need to choose the path where this project will be exist. So this is our path. We can rename with SSIS_testing. So this path is not exist. So first of all, we need to create a folder with the name of SSIS testing. So SSIS testing. Now we can select this folder and here we can rename with SSIS tutorial. Now we can click on OK. Once we click on OK, it will load our SSIS. So this is our SSIS and this is our initial package. So our first step is control flow. So control flow, our first step, then we have data flow. So we gonna discuss about control flow. So here we can define the operations or task execution order. So it wait until previous task will not be completed. Once previous task completed, only then execute next task. So as here we can see, in this example, we have a data flow task. So if this data flow task will be executed successfully, then our execute SQL task will be executed. If this data flow task will be failed, then our script task will be executed. How we can configure our task and how we can set their execution order. So let's move to data flow. So this is our data flow. When we're talking about movement of data, then our data flow task will come into picture. So it has three components. So first is source, then transformation, and then destination. In source, it will pick data from different sources like database, Excel, flat file, XML files. In transformation, it is used to clean up the data which we are getting from source according to our business requirements. And our last step is destination. We will load data into our destination. Destination could be database, Excel, flat file, or anything else. So here we can see we have a Excel source and then we have a transformation which is row count, and then we have a destination which is our database. So this is our data flow task. In data flow task, it will not be wait until our previous task will be completed. Once Excel source get data, it will forward to row count, and once row count will get data, it will forward to our database. So I hope you have understand about control flow. You have understand about data flow as well. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Thank you so much.